Now we'll take a look at two examples of converting a point in rectangular coordinates to polar coordinates. This first example is pretty straightforward, and the second one's a little more challenging. The first step, we want to identify the given coordinates in rectangular form. So this point would be the ordered pair 4, 1, where x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 1. So if we want to determine an ordered pair in polar coordinates, we'd have to determine r and theta. And remember, these are not unique. There's an infinite number of ways to express a point in polar coordinates. But probably the most basic way would be to have a positive r value and a positive theta. So if we did that, we could express the distance here as r, and this here would be theta. So to determine these values, we could sketch a triangle here, label the opposite side 1 and the adjacent side 4. But normally most textbooks just give you these two equations here, r squared equals x squared plus y squared, and tangent theta equals y divided by x, where x doesn't equal 0. But really all we're doing is using right triangle trigonometry to determine these two values. So let's start by determining the value of r. We're going to have r squared equals x squared plus y squared, or 4 squared plus 1 squared. So we have r squared equals 16 plus 1, or 17. If we square root both sides of the equation, we have r equals plus or minus square root 17. Remember that r can be positive or negative. If r is positive, the terminal side of the angle must pass through the point, and if r is negative, it would point in the opposite direction. So let's go ahead and stick to a positive value of r, so I have a square root of 17. Then to determine theta, we'll use a trig equation involving tangent, where tangent theta is equal to y divided by x, in this case 1/4. So now if we take the inverse tangent of both sides, on the left side we have theta, and on the right side we have inverse tangent of 1/4. Now we have to decide if we want to have theta in terms of degrees or radians. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't really matter. Let's go ahead and check our mode. Right now we're in degree mode, so let's go ahead and leave it in degrees. Of course, we could also convert it to radians if needed. So second tangent 1 divided by 4. So theta is approximately 14.0 degrees. And notice how 14 degrees would be in the first quadrant, passing through the given point, which is what we need since we have a positive value for r. Let's go and take a look at a second example. The given point is negative 2, 3. We want to write this using polar coordinates. Again, this might be helpful to visualize this. If we want a positive value for r, the terminal side of theta would have to pass through this point, and this would be one possible angle for theta. So this would be our reference triangle that we could use to help us determine r and theta. So we could label this negative 2 and label this 3. So the hypotenuse, or r squared, would be equal to x squared plus y squared. So we have r squared equals 4 plus 9, that's 13. So we have r equals plus or minus the square root of 13. Now let's see if we can determine the coordinates in polar form with a positive value for r. So according to our formula, tangent theta is going to be equal to y divided by x, which is going to be 3 divided by negative 2, or negative 3/2. So if we take the inverse tangent of both sides, we're going to have theta is equal to inverse tangent negative 3/2. Now remember, the range for inverse tangent is on the open interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So the calculator is not going to give us this angle here that we want, but we can still use it to determine the correct angle for theta. So let's go to our calculator, and we'll determine inverse tangent negative 3/2. And it returns negative 56.3 degrees. Let's go ahead and sketch this to see what's happening. Negative 56.3 degrees would have a terminal side here in the opposite direction. So this angle does have a tangent function value of negative 3/2, but it's not the angle that we need. But we could use it if we used a negative value for r. If we let r equal negative square root 13, then remember the terminal side of theta would point in the opposite direction of the point, which would be negative 56.3 degrees. But if we did have to have a positive value for r, we can still use this information to determine r theta. This tells us that our reference angle in the second quadrant would be 56.3 degrees. So 180 minus 56.3 degrees would give us our angle theta, and that would be 123.7 degrees. So either of these would be correct, but you have to pay close attention to our angle theta because of the range of inverse tangent. So I think it's always important to sketch the point and visualize what you're doing rather than just use the formulas blindly. I hope you found this helpful.